Hi, I am so looking forward to great brand here, Pip McDonald, and what a title for her Gosta. So without any further ado, we'll start off with our counting, and don't forget to join in. Oscailde. Are we ready? A hane,
Hey,
a doe,
Manon,
a
a
tree,
tree,
a tree,
Cathair,
a cat,
a cooig,
a
cooey,
Gosta.
ah, amazing. Okay, hello, my name is Pip. I hope you're enjoying your OE conference experience so far. Thanks for joining the session. And today I will be presenting Strictly Come Digital Dancing. Right. So Strictly Come Dancing is the well-known television show, which I'm sure you're aware of. Participants, including some of our favorite celebrities, collaborate with professional performers and choreographers to perform some of our favorite dances, such as the jive, the Charleston, the tango, and the waltz. Our viewers are treated to a weekly dance competition, which is televised on BBC One. The popular format includes a dance performance followed by a panel of judges. Craig, Darcy, Shirley, Bruno. They rate the dancers and provide a cumulative score with some killer feedback. 10, 9, 10. Okay, you can also check out my Strictly glitter ball. So, as we can see, the Strictly experience is quite something. We can enjoy themed weeks, movie week, Blackpool week, and Halloween week, training videos, live finals, and radical costume changes. But Strictly Come Digital Dancing is all about using dance as a way to explore how learning technologies can make the most of opportunities and challenges of open pedagogy and pivots. So welcome to the possibility of speculative virtual dance, pivot, and open choreography. How do you dance to yours? Is it a quick step, a rumba, a samba, or a foxtrot? Not every academic presentation is cold and formal, and you can make the most of just dancing. So instead of a post-digital pandemic, an epidemic, or an infodemic, you can just dance it off. So whilst we have a wide range of discussions and formats in a conference, it's good to have fun too. So come on, let's dance. Well, why dance? Well, once I went to a conference several years ago, and one of the conference leaders said to me, "I found myself through dance." Now, initially, I thought, "Nah, this is a bit too wild and bohemian for me." But then I thought about it a bit more, and I realized there was actually something in what she said. It's about knowing yourself and about knowing others, and as our professional identities as learning technologists, how we relate to other people and work in a team. As R.D. Lane said in the well-known book, it's about self and other. And remember also that dance is an interdisciplinary act. It moves seamlessly across the curriculum, just like a ballroom tango. An interesting article by Paul Kleeman from Middlesex University explored the extent to which doctors could dance and the improvement that that led in 2012. Over the past year, it may have felt to some extent that we've been held back by the pandemic. Whereas a lot of learning technologists have opened up new pedagogic possibilities, open potential, and new practice, we don't necessarily have to be stuck or remain stuck in pedagogic bubbles or a lack of open learning. And as learning technologists, a pivot can be within a pivot, a digital wheel within a digital wheel. We dance with our bodies, and yet, virtually speaking, we are embodied in our digital practice and our digital capacities. So let's remain safe, but be open to new ideas. So it often feels as learning technologists that we get asked for a moon on a stick, and sometimes it may feel like we are moonwalking. But for many, it is important that learning technology tools we use are fully available and accessible to everyone. Perhaps this could be argued to be a moral issue, an issue of right and wrong. So pedagogy always makes us feel like we put our learners first, and that is the right thing to do, putting the learning into learning technology. So what I'd like to draw your attention to is the Open COVID Pledge, a combination of pandemic pivot and open learning. So they argue that immediate action is required to halt the pandemic and treat those it has affected. So what is the call to action? Well, the Open COVID Pledge encourages to make tools free and accessible to all. And what a great and supportive idea. So how is this done? It's done by, one of the ways this is done is by licenses. And licenses are really powerful things, a bit like the Charleston. Yes, and according to the Strictly Come Dancing official board game, the Charleston is full of bounce, energy and character. It's all about crossing motions, scissor steps and plenty of swivels and turns, a bit like the life of a learning technologist. And don't forget the scary crow killer dance move. So let's play a little bit of Charleston. Maybe it's time for some cha-cha-cha. So if we consult the Strictly Come Dancing official board game again, it's based on the rumba. It's bright and lively. So we ask, what brings brightness and liveliness to open learning? Perhaps checking out the OE Commons online repository of resources will bring the light and pedagogic liveliness to revitalize your pedagogic practice. You can even contribute your own resources, and it is great to give back. So how about a Cuban break? Check out the hubs and the groups on the OER Commons website. When to wiggle, try out the open authoring tool. And don't forget the New Yorks, turning our feet inwards in time, obviously, and as they say, harness the power of the commons. I don't know about you, but I feel perhaps a little bit of ballroom tango needs to happen. So it's all about dramatic, passionate, sharp turns and swivels and head movements. And there's no rise and fall in this dance discipline. It's a bit like the life of a learning technologist with an agenda to create open learning resources. So I hope this sounds familiar, but remember the Spanish drag, the deep lunge, and being carried into a promenade position. Enough of that. Perhaps we can always find a little bit of time to jive. We all know someone that dances like a robot, perhaps learning technologists do, but being a learning technologist is not about glamour all the time. It's about digital grit and working hard. The jive is about knee flicks, twists and turns, lots of energy with precise footwork. And as learning technologists, we are expected to be sharp on the digital ball, and we are expected to have close attention to detail. So in terms of open learning, we need to be aware of the wide range of open licenses and the impact that they can have on how we create and share learning resources. License literacy, that could be the next thing. So watch this space. And in the meantime, let's jive. Life as a learning technologist is not always about being given a series of dance moves to follow, and sometimes we have to create our own and be trailblazers. We have to share our pivot journeys and open dances with other people. So perhaps this could remind us of the paso doble, strong, dramatic walks and powerful foot stamping. So perhaps we can all enjoy a few flamenco checks every now and then and enjoy the pointed toe movements and the coup de pique. This dance move is about having a serious expression. How many learning technologists do you know with a serious expression? And how many times have you had to do this? So bring on a bit of paso doble. For a very quick costume change, it's time for the last waltz. And according to the official Strictly board game, the waltz is considered to be the height of elegance. And yet open learning isn't always an elegant practice. So bring on the ballroom hold, don't throw away the throwaway oversway and prioritise the promenade. Elegance is the key word, and open learning definitely isn't. Learning technology is always a messy business, and that's okay. We have to learn to dance in the digital rain. Sometimes we fall down when we're dancing. Many people have on Strictly dancing, but not every dance can score a 10. Sometimes it's 9, sometimes it's 8. And as Judge Len once said, you floated across the dance floor like butter on a hot crumpet. We can't be, as learning technologists, brilliant and superlative all the time, but we can get up and still dance. So, does anyone remember what it's like to dance in a nightclub or to dance with your friends after a conference? So, learning technology is a group thing. Open learning is a group thing. So what I would like you to invite everybody to do right now is to have a big open dance off. So let's do this, and let's do this Gangnam style. Thank you very much for attending Strictly Come Digital Dancing. I hope you have had a little bit of fun, and remember to keep dancing. Om nom nom.